Commitment 2010 coverage. Tonight, a profile of former Ohio Congressman Steve Chabot.
He is trying to beat out the man who took his job 2 years ago, Democrat Steve Driehaus. News 5's John London joins us with where Chabot stands on the issues. John.
Well, he stands right there on the right, Cheryl. That's where you can always find him, a fiscal conservative Republican who agrees with the Tea Party that government spending's out of control and says unless that's reversed, it'll take us down.
A weekday walk with the guy who represented the West Side for 14 years.
Unfortunately, Cheviot, like so many, you know, small cities, you got a lot of businesses that have literally gone out of business.
Steve Chabot tells News 5 the current administration is anti-business and spend-happy.
Now here's an example of the Obama Driehaus policy here. Look at this place. It's just empty here.
What Chabot sees are signs of a midterm correction. Jobs, 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 he trumpets. And just how do we get them?
The private sector. If right now nobody's investing anything, nobody's hiring anybody, because the policies that are coming out of Washington right now are scaring small businesses and all businesses to death.
Customers are older and they just don't have the extra money.
Stone's Restaurant, serving since 1962, figures this is the worst of those 48 years. If you ride with Chabot in another vintage piece, his 93 Buick.
Lived here most of my life. 50 years, basically, Price Hill and then Westwood.
You get the feeling he's just fine with getting around the way he always has. He opposes the Cincinnati-Cleveland Rail Project, slams the streetcar as a bad idea.
Is it worth us mortgaging our kids and our grandkids' future to pay for that? You know, I think not.
Chabot is a self-described fair market, free market politician. He voted against President Obama's health reform, even though he likes aspects of it.
Young people to remain on their parents' insurance longer, you know, for example, if they're in college, that sort of thing. I like the idea of not penalizing people if they have pre-existing conditions. I want everybody to be able to get health care. Those are good ideas. Unfortunately, they threw in a whole lot of other stuff that makes the bill far too expensive.
Chabot, a major part of the Bush economy, says Republicans weren't as fiscally restrained as they should have been. He hammers Democrats for taking government spending to a higher place.
Hey, I don't trust Republicans or Democrats, to be honest with you. I don't trust Washington in general. And I think we need people that have a healthy skepticism of both parties.
Quoting Chabot, Republicans need to get it right next time. Here's another one. We're headed for a real disaster here if we don't rein this spending in. That's his political forecast, Cheryl, unless the cloud in Congress changes the way he wants it.